Good morning, students. How are you all? You all are good. Have you understood this lesson, this double entry system? And there, the last one that we have studied is the accounting equation approach. There, what is the accounting equation? Assets is equal to liabilities plus capital. Okay, liabilities plus capital. Now we learned the other two, isn't it? If any expenses incurred or loss incurred or any revenue we gain, that will, if the revenue means it will increase the capital, if it is a loss it will reduce the capital. So we can derive this equation in another form, having five accounts equal to liabilities plus capital, then plus revenue. Any revenue, it will increase the capital. And if there is any loss or expenses, that will reduce the capital. So we need to reduce that one. So totally five accounts: asset account, liability account, capital account, revenue account, and expense account. We learned this, all the asset, isn't it? The property owned by the business, the land, building, everything, asset. Then liabilities, the business owes to others. That means the creditors, bills payable, the bank overdraft, all these, the business has to pay to others. Then this is also one liability only, but it is the amount owed by the business to the owner, that is the capital. Okay, then any revenue means all the income. We can say the sale proceeds, whatever we sell in the business, that is the revenue. Then any other income that we receive in the business, that is revenue. Then expenses, all the expense and loss, that in order to sell the goods or for the business, whatever we spend, and any loss incurred in the business, all these are called the expenses. So we need to deduct. So whenever we get one transaction, we have studied it has two aspects, isn't it? For each and every transaction there are two aspects. Here two accounts we can say, okay, two accounts. Here we have studied five accounts, isn't it? So it will affect any two accounts from here. So we should identify that account. Then if it will affect any of these five accounts, either asset or liability or capital, revenue, expense, but two accounts will be there. Either it will increase one asset and it will decrease the other asset, or it will increase one asset and it may increase one liability. Liability means either capital or revenue or expense. So in this account, we have to identify the accounts, then we need to write the equation. Now we will see some of the example. Okay, if one transaction that affects, that increase the capital and increase the asset. Okay, the transaction that increase one asset and increase the capital, what it is, we will see. This is the first transaction. When a businessman starts a business, what he does, we can write that transaction, isn't it? Commenced business, started a business, commenced business with the cash, rupees 1 lakh. Okay, this is the transaction. Okay, this is the transaction. Now we should find out the effect. We should identify the account, which account it is concerned with. Okay, here commenced business with the cash, so very well you know cash is coming in. Okay, then the other one, when we commenced business, we call it as that capital. In order to start the business, the person who is bringing cash, that is called the capital. So it affects two accounts. One is cash and the other is capital. In mind, we have to do all these things. Okay. So cash is, it will increase the asset. Isn't it? Cash is an asset, it will increase the asset. Capital, it will increase the capital. Here which account? Capital account. Okay, cash will come under assets. Okay, assets. So this capital is capital only. So now we should write the accounting equation. Okay, assets is equal to capital. Assets, how much? Assets we can write, that is the cash. Isn't it? What is the capital? Capital only. How much is the asset? Cash, 1 lakh. Equal to 1 lakh. Capital also 1 lakh. So this is the accounting equation. Okay. Now we will see another transaction that decreased the liability and decreased the asset. It will decrease the liability and decrease the asset. That transaction is paid creditors. What is the meaning paid creditors? We paid cash to the creditor. That is understood. Okay, it is not given. Paid creditors means we paid to the creditors. So here, what we paid? That cash. Isn't it? So what are the two accounts involved here? One is cash, the other one is creditors. Understand? Cash and creditors. Here, now we can write the equation. Assets is equal to liabilities plus capital. Here not capital, so we need to write liabilities plus capital. Here it will come under creditors, because creditors is the liability for the business. Okay, business has to pay back to the creditors. They are the suppliers. Understood? Assets here, what is the asset here? Cash. What is the liability? Creditors. So we need to add. Here, we are paying cash. Okay? We are paying cash. So we should write minus the paid creditors amount is 10,000. Okay? So minus 10,000. Equal to creditors also get reduced. So minus 10,000. Understood? It is reducing one liability and it is reducing one asset. Okay, another example. It will decrease one asset and it will increase another asset. Okay, decrease one asset and it increase another asset. We will see one transaction in this one. Okay. Bought furniture costing rupees 5,000 paying by cash. Okay, here we are purchasing furniture, value is 5,000, costing means cost, purchasing price, I told you, isn't it, cost price, that is the acquisition price or cost price, purchasing price, rupees 5,000, paying by cash. Here, what are the two accounts involved in this transaction? It's very essential that you should know how to identify this one account, furniture account, cash account. Both furniture also asset, cash also asset. Now, what is increasing, what is reducing? We are purchasing furniture, so that will increase, isn't it? Cash we are paying, so it will decrease. Understood? One is increasing, another one is decreasing. So, how we will write now? Asset is equal to, every time we need to write the equation. If this is not the way we have to do, Now we are seeing item by item, one transaction only. But they will give all the transactions together that we will do in one illustration. There you will understand more clearly. Okay. Now we are learning each transaction separately. Okay. Now asset is equal to liabilities plus capital. That is the accounting equation, isn't it? Now do not worry about the liabilities and capital because it increase one asset and decrease another asset. So here we should write asset side. What are the assets? Cash, furniture equal to liabilities and capital. Okay. So how much cash? Cash is reducing, isn't it? The amount is 5,000. Plus furniture increasing 5,000 equal to liabilities plus capital. Okay. So here zero it will come. Here also nothing. So it is coming zero. Understood now? When you add and check both the side, it should give same figure. Here also nothing. Here also nothing. Here you see both the side minus 10,000 minus 10,000. What we will get? Zero. Okay. That equation means it should be equated, isn't it? Both the side it must be equal. So shall we see another one? Fourth one. Here one decrease the transaction, that decrease one liability and increase another liability. Understood? It will decrease one liability and it will increase another liability. Here one in illustration they have given accepted a bill drawn by creditors. ₹20,000. You have understood this one? What is bill? I have taught you, I will explain once again. Okay, what is a bill drawn by the creditor? Here we are purchasing, I will explain here. Okay, we are purchasing goods from credit, that is called creditors. We are purchasing goods from creditors, 20,000. For what we are purchasing? On credit. We didn't pay amount. Okay. So what this creditor will do? He will prepare a bill. Okay. Bill of exchange. That is full name is bill of exchange. Nowadays they will say invoice also. Okay. This bill of exchange he will prepare. That will be, that is drawn. Preparing is called drawn. Or drawn. That is drawn. Then the business, we need to accept that one. What is the meaning? That is called accepted. We accepted a bill drawn by the creditors. We accept that we will pay. Okay. When we accept, that is becoming bills payable. Understand that we need to pay. So this, that bill is called bills payable. We need to pay to whom? To the creditors. Understood? That is becoming the bills payable to the creditors. When we accept, it becomes the bills payable. So now here this bills payable is increasing. This is also liability. Both. Okay. We are not paying, but actually we are accepting. But so this bills payable will be, we need to pay. That creditors will reduce. Okay. So bills payable, one account. The other one is two accounts affected. One is bills payable. The other one is creditors. Here both are liability. Understand? This also liability. This also liability. Understood? Here bills payable increases, creditors decreases. What is the meaning? That we need to pay for him 20,000. Now, if we pay this bill only, then that will become, we can pay that one to him. Okay. So, you have understood this two accounts that affect this transaction. Accepted a bill drawn by creditors. Now, if it is increasing the bills payable and decreasing the creditors, both liability. Now, we should write the equation. What is the equation? Accounting equation, asset is equal to capital plus liabilities. Here, asset let it be, isn't it? Asset, capital also as it is. Then, what is increasing? Plus bills payable. Then, what is decreasing? Minus creditors. Okay. So, we need to write plus how much bills payable? 20,000. Creditors, we need to reduce 20,000. Now, how much we are getting? Totally 0. Here also 0. Asset 0. This also 0. Have you understood now? We will see one more transaction that affects more than two accounts. Here, we have seen that affects only two accounts, isn't it? Here, one transaction is there that will affect more than two accounts. Shall we see that example? Okay. Goods costing, that cost price, rupees 30,000, sold for rupees 40,000. Understood? Here for 30,000 goods, we are selling for 40,000. Okay. Now, we will see what are the three accounts affected. Okay. One is goods. We never say that one. Stock we say. Okay. Goods. That in this accounting equation, we will say this is stock. It is reducing. Isn't it? Stock reducing. Then, we are selling. Isn't it? So that nothing is told whether it is cash or credit. So here we can consider as 40,000 we are selling cash. So cash is increasing. Cash how much? 40,000. Okay. How much goods we are selling? 30,000. Goods 30,000 we are selling for 40,000. So what is the remaining 10,000? You are having one product, 10,000 product you are selling for 30,000 product, you just think. Okay, 30,000 things you are selling for 40,000. What is that 10,000? That 10,000 is a profit for you, isn't it? So, this profit, what it will do? What we should do? We have studied, no? It will increase the capital. Any profit or revenue that should be increasing the capital. So we should write this one along with the capital. Now we have you understood? It affects three accounts. One goods, that is stock, another one cash. Goods is reducing because we are selling. So goods reduce, cash increases, then 40,000 we get. That 10,000 you should tally, you know, because that cash we are getting 40,000, goods 30,000, the remaining 10,000 we should tally, this 40. Okay. So, that profit we need to add along with the capital. Now, we will check whether the accounting equation comes correct. Say, write the accounting equation. Asset is equal to liabilities plus capital. What are the asset now? Two asset, isn't it? Stock, cash. Okay. Stock, cash. Then liabilities, nothing, plus here capital, okay, that profit. Now, how much stock? Stock is reducing, so you should write minus 30,000. Minus 30,000. Cash is increasing, isn't it? So, whatever increases, you have to write plus. Whatever is decreasing, we should write minus, okay. Liabilities as it is. Plus capital, how much? 10,000. Now you calculate -30,000 +40,000. That mathematical expression. From 40,000, if we deduct 30,000, how much we will get? 10,000, isn't it? Is equal to, here also we have 10,000. Now, sorry. 10,000 is equal to 10,000. Okay, from 40,000, we deduct 30,000, we will get 10,000. Here also 10,000. So, the accounting equation has come correctly. Have you understood now? So, the simple thing you have to understand is the equation. Asset is equal to liabilities plus capital. Here, a very simple thing, always they will ask for 2 marks. This accounting equation, mostly they will ask the one question. That I will show you. Very simple. Even first standard student can do that one. Okay, I will show you the book itself. Can you see this illustration? One. Okay, because I couldn't show the full book. Here, asset is equal to liabilities plus capital given. Okay, here, first one, A, 30,000 is equal to liabilities 20,000. Isn't it? So, how much we will get here? To get 30,000, we need to add how much amount to get 30,000? 10,000. Isn't it? 10,000 should be added. Then here 60,000 equal to is there now? 60,000 is equal to 25,000 plus 35,000. Isn't it? 25,000 plus 30. How much you will, how will you get that amount? You have to deduct this amount. 20,000 minus 25,000, we will get this amount. Here they have asked the asset how much. These two they have given. How can we calculate? This 25,000 plus 30,000 we need to add. We will get 55,000. Okay? 55,000. Then, the same thing. Next one also. Assets they have asked. Liabilities 10,000. Capital 80,000. So, how much we will get? 80,000 plus 10,000. We will get 90,000. Okay? Then, here, asset is given 25,000, capital given 15,000. So, how much is the liability? From asset, we need to subtract this capital. 25 minus 15, 10,000. Okay? Then, here, in the same way, here 40,000 is equal to, here, 30,000 plus how much? 40,000. 30,000 plus 10,000 is 40,000. Understood enough? That is done here. Okay. So, this one only they will ask almost every time. Two things they will ask like this. Giving this one. Asset is equal to liabilities plus capital. Even simply plus equal to, if they don't give also, you should understand. Asset is equal to liabilities plus capital. Understood? Now, we will see the illustration two. Okay. Show the accounting equation on the basis of the following transactions for Rani, who is dealing in automobiles. Here, started business with cash, 80,000. That first one we did, you know, that one. Then, goods bought on credit from Ramesh, 10,000. Purchased furniture for cash, 6,000. Paid creditors by cash, 8,000. Okay, now this is the model of accounting equation. Can you see? Accounting equation that you have to use both the side of the notebook. I think you are having the accountancy notebook. Okay, that accountancy notebook only you have to use. There they will be both the pages. If you open that page, you will use, you should use two pages, right side, left side, both the pages you have to use. Okay. So, the first page you can take, the particulars column will be there, no? If it is written in Tamil, that is Vibaram. So, for this one, you have to use. First, that date column you leave. Okay, this you use the particulars column. Then, two amount column will be there. Okay, then two amount column, one small paisa column will be there. Don't write anything on the paisa column. Big column, the double line will be there. Okay. That you use this one. Okay. Cash. Stock. Then next page one date column, first column. Okay, that furniture. Then here one small column we have to draw equal. Okay, then the next page particular column is there, no? There you divide that column into three. Okay, use these two. Leave the other column. Okay, capital creditors like this. Okay, but we only have to find out what are the that assets that we are getting. For that we should find out first. Here cash is there. Okay, that one cash. Then goods bought. I have told you that is called stock. Okay, stock. Then purchased furniture. So this is not purchases, it is furniture. So again furniture there. Here creditors, it is, we know that is liability. Okay, liability, creditors. Okay, then it started business is called capital. Capital is coming already. What is the accounting equation? Asset is equal to capital plus liabilities. Okay, there you do not need to write plus and all. We need to draw column only. Okay, now I will show in the notebook, but by using only one page. Understand? I cannot show both the pages in this video. Okay, I will show only one page, but you have to use two pages for this one. This one for first page particulars column, then first amount column, second amount column. This one, the right side page date column. Then one small column will be there. There you write this equal sign. Then the next particulars column you divide equal that equal to this size. Okay, draw two more columns. Then leave the other space. Okay, two columns you draw, and you have to do. But not here. This I will explain. You have to do the exercise 1 and 2. One is that we have done now, that the previous page of that we have, I have shown to you that one, and the next one, this one you have to do. Before that we will see 2-3 illustrations. Okay, first you should write the question number. Okay, question number you have to write. Then in the books of Rani, accounting equation, here you should write transaction. Transaction we should write. Then here assets equal to capital. Here we have creditors, so you can write creditors. First transaction is, what are the assets we have that we can write? Okay, now first we will write. You should write the transaction there. Okay, started business with the cash. Started business with the cash. Here it affects cash account. Cash. So when last year students, I was explaining from here. Okay, the first account that affects. Otherwise, before starting the problem, you have to identify the assets. What are the assets? Okay, so cash. Okay, so it is increasing the cash, isn't it? So plus 80,000. And it is increasing the capital, isn't it? So there also equal to, right? Plus 80,000. Okay, then you have to draw the line. Draw the line, and you should write equation. Then again write the amount, 80,000 plus. Equal to plus 80,000. Now you have to write the second transaction. Okay, what is the second transaction? Question: goods bought on credit from Ramesh. That you can write as credit purchase. Credit purchase. Here, purchases, that means we never write purchase sales. That will affect the stock. So you should write the asset name stock. And credit purchase. So who will come here? Creditors. So it will increase the creditors. Okay. And that stock also it is increasing. Here, asset is also increasing. Liability is also increasing. Understood? So where we should write credit purchases under stock plus what is the amount? 10,000 equal to here under creditors plus 10,000. What is the meaning? We need to pay 10,000 to him. We purchased stock. Stock is also increasing. Liability is also increasing. Now you draw the line with the scale and pencil. Okay, draw the line and write the equation. I think you all understand what I am explaining. Okay, so same thing. All the column you have to fill up. Okay, you have to write the total plus 10,000 equal to here what is there? 80,000 plus 10,000. Both the side it will be equal. If you check, it will be equal on both the side. That is the equation. Here 80 plus 10, here 80 plus 10 equal. Okay. Now we will write the third transaction. What is the third transaction? Purchased furniture for cash. So the same thing you can write. Okay. Purchased furniture for cash. Here, what are the two accounts affecting? One is cash, the other one is furniture. Furniture, it will not come under stock. We need to write furniture. So, these two columns only it will. Here, it will reduce the cash or it will increase the cash. When we purchase furniture, we are paying cash. So, it will reduce the cash. Okay, how much is the amount? 6,000. So you write 6,000, you write straight to this 0, not this 8, 6,000. Then furniture also plus, that is increasing. Okay, 6,000. Then all the other things equal. Now you draw the line and write the amount, total amount. After each and every transaction, we need to total it. From 80,000, if you deduct 6,000, how much we will get? Same way you can deduct, okay? Same way. Without writing these two amount outside, how to deduct? In mind you have to do, okay? Here, 0. From 0, we cannot subtract 6. We need to borrow 1, okay? 10. 10 minus 6, 4. So, what is remaining here? 7. So, what is the amount? Here, plus, greater amount sign plus 74,000. How much here we have got? 10,000. Along with the sign only you have to write. Then plus 6,000 equal to the same amount. 80,000 plus 80,000 plus 10,000. Okay. Now next one, fourth one. Paid creditors by cash. Paid creditors by cash. Here one is creditor, another one is cash. So creditor and cash both are available. So now you should see whether cash is increasing or decreasing. When we paid creditors by cash, the cash will be reducing, isn't it? How much it is? 8,000. So just to write straight to 4, then only it is coming 8,000. Then cash we have written. Creditors, we are paying to creditors. So creditor liability is also decreasing. Okay, minus 8,000. Okay, now we have written. Now we need to write the total. 74 minus 8. The same way you subtract. Okay. 14 minus 8. 14 minus 8, 6. Isn't it? Then 6 is there. Plus sign. Bigger number sign, 6. Then plus 10,000. Plus 6,000. Equal to 80,000 plus 80,000. Then plus 10,000 minus 8,000. Greater number sign, say plus, then 0. Otherwise, in mind also you can do, isn't it? From 10 minus 8 to, you know, you can write. Even then, I am explaining. 10 minus, here we want to borrow 1, 10 minus 8, 2. So, plus 2,000. Understand? Oh, I forgot to write here, isn't it? Equation. We need to write everywhere that equation. Then only next to transaction. Here also, equation. Okay, equation you should write. Now you can draw the full line everywhere. Okay, that one problem over. This they will ask for 5 marks. Understand? They will ask for 5 marks. I think only this much will do. You have to do and see the exercise 1 and 2. Okay, whether it affects two accounts, any doubt you can ask me. Okay, nobody is calling me and asking any doubt. You are free to ask, okay. But my mobile has some problem. Whenever you call that corona talking, if you hear that, that means it is dialing to me. Otherwise, simply rings means, it doesn't mean that it is ringing to me, okay. So confirm that one. If it is ringing and saying that corona detail, then I will attend that call. Okay, even if it is number, I will attend your call and I will answer to you. Okay. Any doubt you can ask me. We will see the third illustration tomorrow. Okay, students, you study and you try to do these two problems and all study all the theory portion. Okay, students, thank you very much.